Welcome to the restaurant show and joining us, our first guests join us from Nasala. This is Ala, who joins us from Nasala, and we've got Jeanette, who is our master mixologist, joining us. We're going to get to you in just a little bit.
Thank you.
But you're here to talk about kombucha, and kombucha is such a cool product. So first, tell us just a little bit about kombucha, what it is.
Sure. Well, kombucha is a fermented tea. It's really high in probiotics, B vitamins, C vitamins. It's slightly effervescent, and it's got a balanced, sweet, and tangy taste to it.
Yeah, and it's a lot of health benefits,
yes.
Right? So tell us a little bit about the health benefits and show us how you make
it. Sure. Well, some of the health benefits that you get, the main thing is probiotics.
Okay.
That's what it's mostly known for. And a lot of people drink it because they get boosts of energy, the probiotics. And basically how you make it is you need sugar, tea, and then what I'm trying to get out of this jar here, this is a SCOBY.
Okay.
Which is a symbiotic culture of bacteria and yeast.
So this is, create the drink itself.
This is the mother culture. So basically this is going to take the sugars, the tannins, the caffeine in the tea, and convert it to the kombucha beverage.
So what is this made out of? Can I touch this?
Sure, yeah.
I can see it's really squishy. Yeah.
And it's pretty funky.
It's soaking in something. So what is that, and what is that made out of?
Sure. So what it's soaking in is a finished kombucha. This is pretty old. So once you keep fermenting it, it eventually turns to vinegar.
Okay.
And that's what you call the starter. So this is the starter, and this is your SCOBY. So what you would do is you would boil some water, you would add your tea and your sugar, and you would let it steep. And at room temperature, you would strain it off into here with your starter and your SCOBY and put a cloth over it.
And so this is something we can do at home.
You can definitely do this at home. We do it on a professional
level. You've got it down. And this is the tea that you use and the sugar. Now, can you use different teas and different sweeteners, or are there?
You can. We believe you should start with just your basic black tea.
Okay.
And we use organic raw cane sugar. Some people use different sugars, but we really believe to get like the best product to use organic raw cane sugar, and that's just how we do it.
So you've perfected this product, and Jeanette, I'm gonna have you hand me a couple of those finished ones. So when you're done, when you've got it all made, this is what we've got. This is our what it comes to, and it comes in lots of different flavors. I see you brought a few with you. So this is lemongrass ginger.
And this is blueberry.
Okay.
And that one right there is peach blush. We do have 7 different flavors.
So this is what we can buy, and how do we do that?
You can go, we are sold pretty much all over Madison in just about every grocery store.
Excellent.
We have bars and restaurants that let you serve it to people just straight up or in cocktails.
So let's get to the cocktail part. These are beautiful finished products, so I'm excited to get into this, but I want to see how the cocktail comes into play. So Jeanette, I know you're a mixologist.
I am.
What are you going to make for us today using the kombucha?
Well, this is called the Acme cocktail. It's kind of a tribute to an old timey cocktail called the Bee's Knees. And I'm using Death's Door gin.
Okay.
So I'm making 2 of these. So I'm gonna.
And now, can you mix the kombucha with any kind of alcohol?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so this is one that you recommend, but you can do a couple.
This is a
things.
Really easy one. It's a real traditional one. And as far as introducing yourself to making kombucha cocktails, it's a pretty fun one.
Okay.
And everybody likes a cocktail and an up drink, up
and
bus.
While you're doing that, I'm just gonna ask you a couple questions, because I know there's some benefits to mixing the kombucha as a cocktail. So what are some of the health benefits and potentially, you know, I hear that it actually helps you feel better too?
Yeah, it kind of erases the hangover before you get the hangover. It's kind of nice that way. Well, my favorite thing about working with kombucha as a mixer is the acidity and the effervescence that kombucha has naturally. It works really nice with spirits, and because the flavor preservation of kombucha, the way the fermentation process, you preserve the flavor of kombucha. And you know, it's really popular to use like artisanal spirits right now. And so like this Death's Door gin I'm using, it has a really nice flavor to it. It's not piney and, you know, turpentine-y. It's really nice and floral. So that, I'm using that. And then this is Old Sugar Distillery, their honey liqueur, which is an amazing thing to play with.
And how many parts of gin have you added now?
Okay, so since I'm making for 2, I just did 4 ounces.
Okay.
So it would be about 2 ounces for 1 cocktail, and now I'm doing 2 ounces of this honey liqueur, which smells super yummy.
Oh yeah, that actually smells really good. You can smell the honey flavor, definitely.
Yeah, these guys do great work. So then I'm just gonna take that and I'm gonna shake it with a shaker here. It's a
fancy shaker.
Yeah, well, that's good. So okay. You're going to pour that in here, and then uh-huh. you add the kombucha.
And then you finish it with the kombucha, because most times, look at that color, it's really pretty.
Very pretty. It smells really good, too. I can't believe you haven't even added anything yet, but we'll get that in there, and I'm sure that'll just add to it. So. You're going to use the lemongrass ginger in this one.
Yep, this is the lemongrass ginger.
4 ounces of the gin, 2 ounces of
the old sugar honey liqueur. Okay. Uh-huh.
And then about how many ounces of the kombucha are you mixing?
It's going to be 2 ounces per glass.
Okay, gotcha. So. All right, so real quick, we got to kind of wrap up here, but I want to find out if I want to get some of these drinks out and about with kombucha, what kind of other bars out there that are going to serve these cocktails
several.
Right here in town?
Yeah, okay. Several. Not this one, I just came up with this one for y'all, but... you can go to several bars. Jenna's Lounge, Notchville,
Weary Traveler. Alchemy.
Okay, great.
Yeah, lots of bars. Just go to our website. We have a list of all the bars that sell.
Okay. And really quick, too, before we go, I want to ask you about some events coming up. Anything special that we can get into with kombucha and Nasala in particular?
Yeah, we have, we're doing a dinner, pairing party dinner at Mermaid Cafe on the 17th. And then in May, the first week of May is really busy for us. We're taking part in the craft beer week and having a shandy party at Jenna's, a happy hour party.
Very cool.
And then, yeah, some lot of other things.
Lots of great events. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for showing us these great cocktails.
Thank you.
I'm going to have to have you try them. Can I have a
please.
Sip? All right.
Yeah.
I need somebody to cheers
I'll
me
cheers
here.
I'll cheers you if you don't mind. If you don't mind, Nala.
They smell so good.
I'll just cheers vicariously through the both of you.
Very good. Awesome. Thank you so much, Ala and Jeanette, for joining us and mixing these great cocktails. We'll definitely check out some of those places and those events you have coming up.
Cool. Thank you.
And we are going to be right back with more right here on The Restaurant Show.
Na zdorovya.
Stay right where you are, because after the break, we've got Brat and Brow here, who's going to show us how to make a double brat.